It's day two of 30 days of selling online.
There's the plan.
And I'm the man. Or, wait, not the man. I'm the girl. I'm the woman. I'm the chick. I don't know. Anyway, I'm the person that is going to show you how you too can sell online, how easy it is, and how it takes nothing more than consistency and a dedication to do it. So again, day two of 30 days of selling online. So let's do this. Yesterday was a little wackadoodle. Sorry for the wackadoodle yesterday, but like I said, the AC was out. So that was kind of a problem, but we've got the AC. We've got a new AC unit. Yay! Yay for AC! So today is day two of 30 days selling online. Pardon my but I've got the today. Okay, so today what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be listing on Amazon and showing y'all how to do that. And remember, one of the goals is that I'm not going to work more than 3 hours a day. So, no, the video is not 3 hours long, as you can tell by looking. Oh, hello, radio's on. As you can tell by looking on the counter below the video, but told you I got the eyes. But what I am going to do is work that time, and then at the end I'll come back and tell y'all, you know, how many I listed. So that's the first thing. And then I'm also going to answer a couple of questions that y'all have asked me. So if you have questions, be sure to leave it in the comments below on any video, or you can, of course, send me a direct message. But the questions I'm going to answer today are, what should I sell, and what does sell?
Hey, everybody. Okay, let's get going. I'm not going to waste a lot of time here with yammer yammer. So we're going to go to Amazon. And this is the main page when you come to Amazon. Just to let y'all know, I am not going to be doing a whole bunch of tutorials. First of all, I'm not going to speak either, it seems. I'm not going to be doing a bunch of tutorials about how to, you know, sign up with these different platforms or whatever. You're going to have to do that yourself, because honestly, they're going to have much better information, obviously, on their website of how to be part of them than me having to do a tutorial of a tutorial of a tutorial. That's going to waste everybody's time. But basically, you just scroll all the way down. You can go to sell on Amazon. And again, I'm just showing you this to show you where it is. Okay. And then there's all different kind of things here. You know, if you're going to have fewer than 40 items a month, you know, it's selling fees and all that kind of stuff. So just again, look at the tutorials, look at the different stuff up here. Okay. But what we're going to do is we're going to go back to just regular old Amazon. And let's see. I'm going to sign in. And let's enter this. That should be right. I think my thumb just hit the mic, so sorry for that little whoosh sound. Okay, so here I am. So once you're inside of it, you go to your account. I go to my account, and I go to my seller account. Hopefully y'all are seeing this. I'm kind of over to the right of the screen. I'm trying not to go too fast to be irritating, but I do want to show y'all what's going on. Now, I just clicked the inventory tab, and you'll notice that you have an active and an inactive. I honestly don't even know if I took everything out of inactive. Okay, good. I have a bunch of stuff here that I'm actually going to just be loading manually. Once you have put in inventory items that are active selling online, this is going to list out. I'll show you at the end you know, of this video. I'll show y'all what that looks like, but I am going to show you how to list a book specifically. This one, sorry for the bad quality of the video here or the image, but this is just, these are the books that I'm going to be you know, listing, or some of them. And this is Eclipse, and then I want y'all to know that you're going to have to make sure that you have the UPC, which is located, that's what the UPC code is right there. You'll also see that it says ISBN number, and on Amazon you can list with either one of those things. Okay, so back over here to Amazon, what we're going to do, and I'm just going to be real brief about it. Again, add a product, and then this screen comes up, and then actually let me refresh that because I took that out before y'all could read it. So it says enter your product name, your UPC, your EAN, your ISBN, or your ASIN. These are all just numbers. It's basically your UPC code. ISBN is for books and media. UPC is like for products and things like that. So any of those numbers you can do here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to click it. I'm going to get my Eclipse book, which is a hardcover. And there's a 10-digit and a 13-digit ISBN. I always do the whole thing. And I do not include the dashes and such. Make sure I got this right. 036290. Okay, and there it is right there. It's a special edition. Now, what I normally do is a lot of times, luckily, sorry for that. A lot of times we'll have more results, but luckily this only had one. So what I want to do here is I'm going to right click to open in a new tab. I want to make sure that this is the book that I've got. So you can see here, the picture looks the same. Yes, I'm checking it, hard cover. Yes, so that's the same. I scroll if it'll let me. I've got so much running right now on the computer, it's probably going to crud out on me. But I scroll down, and I just want to make sure that this is the right book. And indeed it is. So I'm going to click that off, and I'm going to put sell yours up here. Y'all see me click over there on that side. Okay. I don't enter a seller SKU. This is unique. If you don't enter it, one will be created. I never do this. If you want to get really advanced and if you're doing a ton of different books, then you can do that. It's not a problem. Okay. Now the condition on this is I'm going to put, let me take a look at it here. It looks really good that there are some crinkles on the bottom pages. And then I always like to try to open it, and y'all can't actually see me doing this, but I thumb through it to make sure that there's no writing in there, and I don't see any writing, I don't see anybody's name, there's no signature. So I'm going to put on here, very good, okay, I get it, Windows, leave me alone, please. And then I will put in here, let's see, great condition. Somewhere due to, some shelf wear evident, E-V-I-D-E-N-T, appears to have not been read. Notice these words that I'm using, okay? And then I always like to check, if you put a book, if you put the spine of the book in your hand and let it fall open, if it doesn't fall open, that means the binding has not been cracked. And if it hadn't, I would put in here, binding not. Oh, good Lord. Uh-oh. What's happening? Binding not cracked. But that's not the case on this one, so I'm going to take that off. Great addition to your collection. Now, if you ever are on Amazon, you'll notice that a lot of people it's still recording. Okay. A lot of people will not put a description here. They'll put like where the book is shipped from or whatever, but I don't. I always like to do this. Now, skip, write how much ever you want. Okay, you have a lot of room to write a lot of comment. I would probably do more, but again, I'm doing this for short sake. Okay, here they're going to show you, if there's others listed, they're going to show you what the pricing is. Now you can look over here and see what competing offers are by doing a right click on your mouse. You can open any of these in a new tab. All right, so none of mine are new, collectible, or anything like that. It's in the used category. So here you can see it's that. Now let me show you what that's going to look like. Okay, here is the actual book. Now, you can see here that, let me make this a little bit smaller. This is kind of large. There we go. Oh, they've changed their format too, so this looks very different. All right, you'll see the first top ones, it's Fulfillment by Amazon. Okay, a lot of people like that, a lot of people don't. So what I do is I skip down here, and you can see it says a penny plus $3.99 shipping. Now those prices equate to $3.99 plus no shipping. Okay, so it's all about the same, and then you can just kind of scroll down. See, there's a whole bunch that are for a penny. Okay, so what I'm probably going to do is, and I'm kind of opposite of the game a lot of times, but I'm going to put on here a dollar and then $3.99 plus shipping. Again, I'm probably not going to make a lot of money on this one, but again, this is more for y'all's purposes. If you want to set a sales price, you can, of how much and the date. That's really handy for people who have a lot of stuff and maybe a holiday is coming up or something like that, and they want certain categories to be on sale. So that's something to remember. There's only one quantity. I always go ahead and do the starting date of when I'm listing it. If you have more coming in, you can always do a restock date. Country of publication, import designation, and country is labeled. I usually leave these blank. It has never worked against me, but if you have that information, if you want to be that detailed, it's even better for your buyer. Okay, I usually only choose standard shipping because I don't want to bust through myself. Sometimes I'll click the 3 to 5 days. Only qualified sellers can do that, and I am a qualified seller, so that's why it's available for me. For these purposes, I'll go ahead and check it just to show y'all. But normally I do not do expedited 2-day, 1-day international, or expedited international, but that's my choices. You can do what you want. And then I do save and finish. And then there it is right there. Now you'll notice it's not up here. It does take a little bit of time. It takes up to 15 minutes for your changes to propagate. Okay. And so there you go. That is the first book. And like I said, I'm going to spend about 3 hours. So I will come back and show y'all what it looks like at the end.
As I said, at the end of doing all that, I was going to come back and let y'all know. And then after this little blurb, I'll give you the answers to the questions that I mentioned at the beginning of the video. So today I spent probably about 1.5 to 2 hours. There was kind of some flex in there because you'll see on tomorrow's video, actually, while I was recording, while I was writing down my inventory, I filmed it, and that's actually going to go in tomorrow. So there was a little bit of time in there for setup and all that. But basically, in about 1.5-hour-ish, I listed 25 books on Amazon, and I inventoried those 25 books onto the inventory sheet again, which you will see tomorrow. So that was my efforts today. And the reason why I'm doing this, I'm going to try to remember to note it every day. But at the end of each week, I'm also going to give y'all a rundown of total hours worked, total inventory items listed, and maybe even total amount of inventory. I think that's going to be ridiculous though, actually, now that I'm saying that. So I think I'll do total items, total time it took, and then when things sell, then I'll give money numbers because it's kind of pointless to do it ahead of time. But anyway, that was it. So now let's go on to the question. One of the questions I get asked the most frequently is, what should I sell? A lot of people, they want to sell online. The idea intrigues them, you know, of eBay, Amazon. Maybe they're a buyer of things online and they want to tap into it. So if you fall in that category, what's a category? If you fall into that category, then good for you. So to answer your question, I've talked about this a lot in many of my other videos. You can go to my YouTube channel page and check out all my different, I have a stray hair on me, all my different videos about selling online, and you'll find a lot of these questions answered. But I really wanted to highlight them, you know, in this 30-day series. So, you know, my whole thing that I always say to people, number one, is if you're just getting started and you have like little to no experience in online selling, the best place to start is always going to be with what you have in your own home. Now that doesn't necessarily mean that that's what you have to sell forever, but to get the experience and to get your feet wet with whatever platform you're going to use, start with what you've got at home. Now a lot of people are like, oh no, I don't want to get rid of anything. Okay, if you're that attitude, then you're a hoarder and you need to get over it. And again, you know, you don't have to sell everything and end up with nothing, but that's, you know, that's a good place to start. So now beyond that, beyond having your own things in your house to sell, my question I have to ask in response to the question of what should I sell is, what do you like? What do you enjoy? Or what do you want to learn about? You know, if you're going to do this for a business, whether part-time or full-time or temporarily or long-term, you know, it's going to help you if you have an interest in some level of the product that you're going to sell. Now, some people, you know, and this is more videos later, but, you know, when you're talking about sourcing things, there's the garage sale, estate sale, thrift shop avenue. There's, you know, buying overruns and seconds, which are going to be new products. And there's, you know, consigning for people, which is a totally different ball game. But generally speaking, online, unless you have a lot of money right now and you're going to get into, you know, big time buying overruns and stuff like that and selling huge quantities of stuff, chances are you're going to be selling one item, and that's going to be the only one that you have. And you'll learn about that item, and then you may never see an item like that again. So that's why I always say, you know, what do you like? What do you enjoy? Or what do you want to learn about? Because if you like or enjoy something already, you already have a taste for it. You already have a little experience in that product type. And so you're already going to be keyed up to do that. And then what do you want to learn about? Let's say that you've, you know, you want to learn about vintage toys, okay? Well, then as you go out sourcing, you're going to be looking for vintage toys, and then you're going to start learning more and more about that in the industry. So I hope that helps of what should I sell, and let's go on to the next question. The question just basically is, what does sell? Now, this is different than what should I sell. It's more, what does sell online? And the short answer is everything. I've seen everything sell online, and it varies from time to time and from year to year, and what's popular one year may not be the next. But I have seen everything sell online, even broken stuff, damaged stuff. You know, if it's old and has any value to it, even if it's broken or damaged, people will buy that for parts to fix up things. So, you know, the key of it is to list the item, relist the item, and you're going to do that like two or three times. And then if you find that the item is still not selling, then you can consider holding off for a little bit of time, let a few months pass, relist it again a couple of times, and then if it still does not sell, go ahead and take individual items and start putting them into a lot on a site like eBay or Bonanza or something like that. Amazon, you can't do lots, but all the other venues you can.
Hey, sorry it has been such a long video, but hopefully you're getting a lot out of it. I'm going to work very hard on making the videos much shorter for the rest of the 30 days. But today was my first day working through this, and I'm getting, you know, I kind of do it backwards as I go through. I'll figure out what I want to do, and then I can cut the video accordingly. But hopefully those questions that were answered helped you out. Hopefully you saw, you know, how easy it is to list books, for example, on Amazon. So coming up tomorrow on tomorrow's video, you're going to find out, you know, about keeping track of your inventory. I do it a very basic way. You can get very complicated or you can get more in depth, but I'm pretty simple, so I keep it really simple. So we're going to talk about that tomorrow, keeping track of your inventory. Also, I'm going to give you a couple of tips specifically on when you're listing things like books, or really anything like that on Amazon, any kind of media. I'm going to give you a couple of indicators that you will want to include in your descriptions all the time. And then also I'm going to answer the question of where should I sell? In other words, what platform is going to be the best and things like that. So that is coming up tomorrow. And on that note, and on this very lengthy video, thank you if you're watching it to the very end. Let me know in the comments below if you watched the whole thing, and you will get bonus points today. But on that note, y'all have a delicious, delightful, delirious day. And I will see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.